All right, round two. My name is Phil Kohler. I'm here with Susana Polo.
Hello.
And we had Griffin McElroy joining us earlier today when we initially tried to log in and open our Hearthstone Journey to Un'Goro packs. Sadly, the servers were not having it. They did not want to help us out there. But
it was a sad time. It was a sad time in our lives.
It was a very sad time. So sadly, Griffin is no longer able to join us. He has some other stuff going on. But Susana,
but Phil, this looks like Hearthstone.
This is Hearthstone. Not only is it Hearthstone, but like, look at how many packs I've got here.
God, Phil, that's so many.
We better get started.
I have to be real with you. Opening packs is fun, but I get to about 20, and then I'm like, this is a slog.
Well, that's good, because after you see all mine, you're going to want to, like, just rush through yours. All right, so here we go. Just getting started here. We've got this new Paladin Discover Secret, which I think is pretty weak, because Paladin Secrets are pretty weak, but there you go. It's probably good for Wild, maybe for, like, a Secret Paladin in
but
Wild.
But we no longer have that, like, Paladin card that puts six secrets on your board.
Yeah. But that's what I'm saying, like, for Wild, if you're playing that still, maybe that's good still. Another secret one here, the Arcanologist, draw a secret from your deck, for a mage.
It's not awful.
I guess it probably thins out your deck some. If you're playing some new version of Freeze Mage, you can get the secrets you need much easier. The Priest Radiant Elemental, which makes your spells cost less. It's sort of like the mage's whatever they're called, the mage that makes your spells cost less.
Yes, apprentice.
That one.
I think
Sorcerer's Apprentice. Yeah.
Yes.
but the difference is that it's a 2/3 rather than a 3/2. I'm not a huge fan of the 2/3 versus 3/2. Although some people have pointed out that's better for Priest because you can keep healing it and stuff. Maybe it'll be good. Hot Springs Guardian. This is the first elemental we've opened up. Shaman card. Taunt. Restore 3 health. 2/4. Not bad. It's solid. And in an elemental deck, I'm sure.
Devil Sword Egg is pretty cool.
Devil Sword
Egg.
Summon a 5/5 Devil Sword when it dies. It's a 0/3. Obviously, if you can get that shielded up or something, or you just put it on so that if the enemy does a board clear, you know, you'll have something.
Yeah, I can see that fitting very nicely in a Hunter deck.
Mm-hmm. I can definitely see that as well. All right, let's keep on a rolling.
Ooh.
First legendary. So we got to keep track of how many legendaries. We've got 131 packs, and we want to keep track of how many legendaries we get. All right, so let's before we open the legendary.
Yes. Yeah.
Lucari Fellhound. This is a taunt, discard 2 cards for the Warlock, 3/8. Pretty good stats for a 4 cost, and also discard Warlock is going to be huge this expansion.
Yeah, isn't the Warlock quest card discard related?
It is, and also the new Warlock legendary minion is discard related. The Sated Threshodon, I just like this one because of it conceptually. Like, so it's a 7-cost 5/7. When it dies, it summons 3/1/1 Murlocs. So, like, the idea of it's like, oh yeah, it's just a sea thing that ate the Murlocs. And then the warrior gets Molten Blade, which transforms into a different weapon each turn that it's in your hand. Can transform into non-warrior weapons, so that's kind of cool. Let's...
All right.
Open the way gate! Yes! I love that we immediately started off with the most, in my opinion, the most hype quest possible.
That's so weird.
So, yeah, the quest is to... we already got some super jealous here. The quest is to open... to cast 6 spells that didn't start in your deck.
So to steal spells or to discover spells.
Yeah, so stuff that you discover, stuff that you get from, like, Babbling Book, that kind of stuff.
Right.
And what you get out of it...
That mage secret that copies the spell. Yeah.
And what you get out of it is Time Warp, which is incredibly powerful. It is a 5-cost spell that lets you take another turn. Which is...
Whoa!
Almost certain to be one of the most powerful. Like, I think the Hearthstone
that is
devs.
A crazy thing.
Yeah, the Hearthstone devs have gone on record as saying, like, they're a little bit scared that this will be OP. It's yeah. possible. It's entirely possible that like 2 months from now, we're gonna be in the middle of this meta, this new meta, and
we're gonna be
like
chest deep.
We're gonna be like, oh, time warp is the worst. but right now, today, I'm stoked.
Yeah.
I'm definitely gonna try that out. That is one of the first decks I want to try making for sure. All right, what do we got? What do we got? Nothing big.
Just your average.
Here's a nice new elemental. 7 cost, 4/8 with Wind Fury. You know, in an elemental deck, I could definitely see this potentially working out. Interesting rogue card here. It's a 4 cost, 3/3 weapon. Costs 1 less for each card you've played from another class. So kind of like continuing that to push that sort of burgle rogue, that idea of like steal your other class, your opponent class's cards.
Yeah.
The shaman, 4 cost, deal 4 damage to a minion, restore 4 health to your hero, which it's fine. I don't think it's that great, but it's fine. I think like Jade Lightning is better and still exists, so yeah. Giant Mastodon, just a big beefy taunt.
Just a
6/10.
Big beefy guy.
Yeah. Jeweled Macaw, add a random beast to your hand. I know you're particularly looking forward to Beast Hunter being a thing.
Yes.
So I think this is, if Beast Hunter becomes a thing, this is one of the cards that I think will probably be a big part of Beast Hunter. Another interesting thing about this as well is it's a 1 cost, and the Beast Quest is all about playing 1 cost minions, so will be important for that, I believe. Let's go. Let's roll it. Okay. We'll go with that. Alright, so here's the new Hunter spell, Grievous Bite. 2 damage to a minion, 1 damage to adjacent minions.
Alright,
Like a mini explosive shot.
Yeah, or a little tiny different swipe.
Yeah, not bad. Glacial Shard is just a 1-cost elemental that freezes an enemy. Pretty good, I think.
Yeah,
solid.
Pretty good.
Ravasar Runt, if you control at least 2 other minions, adapt. And this is a beast one as well. So again, if you're looking to put together any sort of beast-related deck, whether that's Hunter, Druid, or what have you, and especially if it's like low-cost minions, you're probably going to have more than 2 on the board at any one time. I think there's a lot of potential for this. Nesting Rock. If you control at least 2 other minions, gain taunt. It's another interesting one. 4/7. Pretty good.
It wants to protect its babies.
Have we talked about adapt? We should probably talk
about
adapt.
We have not talked about adapt yet.
Yeah. So that's a new mechanic. It works sort of like Discover, where you're given 3 options. There's 10 total options you can get, and it's stuff like gain +3 attack, gain +3 health, gain stealth.
And they're all like elemental themed or something, right?
No, well, I mean, like, I think the maybe like the wording of them is, but the actual like stuff you're getting is just pretty generic.
Right.
Like, it's the regular Hearthstone mechanics. Gain can't be targeted by spells, for example. I think this is a really cool paladin card. So this is a paladin spell called Spike Ridged Steed. You give a minion +2/+6, and taunt. And when it dies, you summon a Stegodon, which is like another minion that we'll probably see pop up at some point. But I love it. Like, conceptually, I love it. I think it's just super powerful as well. It's a cool
buff. So with Adapter, you have 10 to choose from, but it only gives you 3. And
yeah, there's 10 possible. You only get 3 that you can choose from anytime you adapt. Okay, here we're seeing some repeats finally. There we go. 2 of these already.
Yeah.
Crackling Razor Maw. Adapt a friendly beast, so again, and it's a beast itself as well. Again, going into that Beast Hunter, 2 cost, 3/2, which is always good stats. Volatile Elemental, Death Rattle, deal 3 damage to a random enemy minion. So it's a pretty weak cost thing, but has has the potential to help clear the board for you. All right. We're doing good. We're making progress.
Yeah, getting through it.
Oh, look at that golden. So we've got this another nice little paladin spell. Just a very simple 1 cost, adapt a friendly minion, which I like. It's it's simple. It's clear. It's easy.
It's the way that you're making me feel tonight.
Thank you. Tolvir Stone Shaper. Battle Cry. If you played an elemental last turn, gain taunt and divine shield. So this is kind of digging into the way that these elementals are buffed up. A lot of the elemental stuff, a lot of the elemental interactions are not, if you control an elemental now, it's if you played an elemental last turn, which is kind of interesting. It kind of it forces you.
Yeah,
if
you're I've seen that checks on a number of cards. So far.
if you're running an elemental deck, you need to kind of plan ahead, essentially. Tolvir Stone Shaper is great too because it's basically Sentient Shieldmaster, but better if you're in an elemental deck.
Right.
So that's pretty cool. I've seen some of my friends opening up legendaries here. Hopefully we can get some rolling. Oh, they're golden. And I love this guy because look at the cute little turtle.
This is that egg is wiggling back and forth in the gold card. I'd say the gold card animations have significantly improved over the course of the game.
Yeah, they definitely have. So this is the Tortolan Forager. Battlecry, add a random minion with 5 or more attack to your hand. The Druid quest is actually based around playing minions with 5 or more attack.
Oh, right. Yeah, that makes sense.
But this is kind of interesting because there's just a huge pool that it can draw from of minions with 5 or more attack. There's a lot of variety there. Primal Fin Lookout, if you're looking for new Murlocs, here you go. If you control a Murloc, discover a Murloc. If you control another Murloc other than Primal Fin Lookout, that is. Firefly, going to be great for the elemental decks. Battlecry, add a 1/2 elemental to your hand. So you get to play a 1/2, and you also get another one in your hand for playing later, or playing the same turn, possibly. Cornered Sentry is interesting. This is a warrior-only card. It's Taunt, 2/6 for 2, so basically the Dirtier Rat stats. But summons 3 1/1 Raptors for your opponent, so the idea is, like, you're giving your opponent the ability to take out half of this opponent.
Unless you combo it with some of the warrior abilities.
Exactly. Interesting card, certainly, and they're definitely continuing to try to make Taunt Warrior a thing. Which we'll see about that.
Ooh. Well, at least there's 2.
Alright, Igneous Elemental. Death Rattle, add 2 1/2 elementals to your hand. So again, just a continuing to play off of that, getting cheap elementals into your hand. We've seen the Fellhound. Tortolan Shell Razor. Here's another one of those cute turtles. 2/6 Taunt. Death Rattle, give a friendly minion +1/+1. I think this is pretty good, honestly. And again, ties into the Priest Quest, which is all about playing Death Rattle minions. Galaka Crawler. Battlecry, destroy a pirate and gain +1/+1. So if you're hating those pirate decks, here you go.
That's a bit of a play on. There's another crab minion, but it eats more.
Hungry crab. Crab. And then Vicious Fledgling. After this minion attacks a hero, adapt. One of those things where if you can keep this alive, it has the potential to adapt a lot, and that would be pretty powerful.
Yeah.
But you probably can't keep it alive.
Probably not, yeah.
In most cases. All right, we got doubles here. 2 Verdant Longnecks. This is a Druid Beast Battlecry Adapt. Just a 5-cost 5/4, and you get to adapt it once. The Razor Petal Lasher is a 2-cost 2/2 for the Rogue. Add Razor Petal to your hand that deals 1 damage. I've heard a lot of people criticizing this because you're playing a 2-cost, and then you have to play more to get those damage out. But I think I could see it still working in, like, combo decks where you need as many pieces to combo off of as possible.
Yeah.
And then Molten Reflection, choose a friendly minion and summon a copy of it. This is a pretty cool spell. A lot of potential to be quite powerful. All right. Let's roll. Ooh. All right, we've got the Fireplume Phoenix. Battlecry, deal 2 damage. Pretty good. It's a 4-cost, so.
Yeah. Now, what is poisonous? I don't think I know what that is.
So that's new.
Oh, wait, no. That's, okay, yeah,
it
is new.
It's new that...
It is condensed to that.
Exactly. Yes, okay. So it's what used to be on a card when it would say any minion that takes damage from this minion gets destroyed or whatever the phrasing was.
Yeah.
Or destroy any minion damaged by this. I guess that's what it says there. Now they've put that into one keyword, which is poisonous. One of the keywords you can get from adapt. And just kind of cleans up the game a little bit, makes it a little bit...
Yeah.
Puts that all under one keyword. I like this guy because he's a snail.
I like him because he's a stubborn gastropod.
Yeah.
There's something very cute about that.
The Light Fuse Stegadon, this paladin minion that will adapt your Silverhand recruits. One interesting point about this is no matter how many recruits you have out, you're choosing one adapt for all of them.
Interesting. So that's still really interesting.
Yeah. And then the Biteweed, which is basically like a mini Edwin Van Cleef, gain +1/+1 for each card you've played this turn. So rogue combo decks in theory could have more to go off of than just Edwin, although I feel like you just want to save your combo stuff for Edwin anyways.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, we've seen Elder Longneck, I think, is new. If you're holding a minion with 5 or more attack, adapt. And it's a 3-cost 5/1. Again, plays into that druid quest of trying to play minions that have 5 or more attack, but obviously pretty weak. So it's tough. Even with an adapt, that's pretty weak.
Yeah.
And then Mirage Caller, Priest, Battlecry, choose a friendly minion, summon a 1/1 copy of it. Which is all interesting. Right. That's an interesting card.
I can see that working out for some of the ongoing effects that Priest cards have.
There's probably some potential there. Ooh.
Oh, hey.
All right, so we'll do this. All these Sated Threshodons. Lost in the Jungle is a really cool paladin spell. 1-cost, summon 2/1/1 Silverhand recruits. Just to get those out there. Nice early paladin spell. Not a lot of really good early game paladin stuff, so that's good. Feeding Time is not a great warlock spell. 5-cost.
No, it is not.
Deal 3 damage to a minion, summon 3/1/1 Tarot Axes.
I like the image of that, though.
It's not terrible, but 5 is a lot to pay for that.
Yeah.
What do we got? Oh, this is the Rogue quest legendary. Play 4 minions with the same name. So you're going to have to be either using like Gang Up or Shadow Step or whatever it is to get 4 minions with the same name out there. And your reward is Crystal Core, which is a spell that makes it so that for the rest of the game, all of your minions have 5 attack and 5 health, I believe.
Okay.
Let me double check just to make sure. But I believe that is how that works. Which is an interesting card. I don't know that I necessarily get it.
Yeah.
But it's interesting. That is correct, by the way. Alright, so we're starting to see a lot of repeats now.
Yep.
All stuff we've seen before. We're all good on that. Tar Lurker is new. The Tar minions are some of my favorite ones. There's a few of them, but the Warlock gets one that is a 5-cost 1/7, but it has +3 attack on your opponent's turn, and it's a taunt.
So it's a 4/7.
It's a 4/7 on your opponent's turn, and you know it's a taunt, so they have to get past it.
Right.
I dig that a lot.
That's a very interesting mechanic.
Yeah, it's really good for helping to slow stuff down against aggro decks, and it's just a really smart, interesting play on stuff. Shimmering Tempest, Death Rattle, add a random mage spell to your hand. Obviously, this helps that quest, which is good. We need that. That's going in my mage deck, for sure. We're up to 2 legendaries. All right, so we got Binding Heal, which is just restore 5 health to a minion and your hero. There's potential for that. That's pretty good.
Yeah, at that low cost, you know.
Here's another 1-cost beast for Hunter, the Raptor Hatchling, and Death Rattle. Shuffle a 4/3 Raptor into your deck. So
I don't have anything to say except that I'm excited about dinosaurs, Phil.
Yeah, dinosaurs and hunters in particular. I love this pre-spell. This is one of my favorites. There's a couple of really good pre-spells, and this is one of them. Discover a copy of a spell in your deck. You know, if you plan your deck correctly, this just does such a good job of letting you pull out exactly the piece you need when you need it. Obviously, you have to pay for it, but still, I think there's a lot of potential there. A lot of potential in all of this. Here's a simple warrior spell. Gain 5 armor.
Yep. I'm going to hate that card.
Then we got Mana Bind, the new mage secret, which you mentioned earlier. When your opponent casts a spell, add a copy of that to your hand that costs zero, which is a really interesting interesting new secret. I feel like secrets are difficult. I feel like the older Hearthstone gets, the more limited the secret space is, right? But this is definitely a really cool one. I like it.
Yeah, and it fits right in with their quest.
Yep, absolutely. Alright. Ooh, Golden Rare. Okay, so we got a Tolvir Warden, which is a hunter card. Draw 2 1-cost minions from your deck. It's 5-cost 3/5, which isn't great, and drawing 2 1-cost minions, you know, from turn 5 on isn't great. But again, if you're trying to, the important things about this, there's two. One, if you want to fulfill that hunter quest, and two, if you want to thin out your deck, right? If you want to pull out some of those 1/1s so that in subsequent turns, you're not necessarily drawing those when you need something bigger. We've got the Giant Wasp, which is a new beast. Stealth and poisonous, which is nice. And then we've got the Charge Devilsaur, which
is... that's a super interesting card text.
I believe this is the only charge minion in this expansion, and they're really downplaying charge. I was tweeting about this last night, but what's interesting about this one, is it has charge, but you can't attack heroes this turn, so you can't use this to just, like, end the game, right?
Yeah.
Which is pretty, pretty interesting. Let's see here. Alright, all repeats, I think. As we go, we should start seeing a lot more repeats.
Hallucination is new.
Yeah, this is again, just a real simple, elegant rogue card. Discover a card from your opponent's class. The fact that it's discover, you know, immediately to me makes it much more useful than something like Burgle, because it's, you know, I wouldn't say there's so many times, but there's a lot of times when I'm using those rogue cards like Burgle or that steal, any of the rogue cards that steal an opponent's card, or a card from your opponent's class, you just get something that doesn't work with your deck. The fact that you're discovering that you have a choice, you can probably find something useful, right?
Yeah, and then Tar Creeper is just your neutral tar.
Yes, plus 2 attack during your opponent's turn, so it becomes a 3/5 for 3, which is great. Flame Geyser is a pretty cool spell. Deal 2 damage, add a 1/2 elemental to your hand. So if you're doing a mage elemental deck, this will probably fit right in. And Cruel Dynomancer is incredible.
Cruel Dynomancer will make it be way less frustrating to play a discard warlock.
It's so good. Summon a random minion that you discarded this game. Like, that's just absurdly good. That's going to be very, very good. Frozen Crusher is new. After this minion attacks, freeze it. That's a weird one. It's a 6-cost 8/8. Pretty weird.
Very interesting.
It is an elemental. Oh yeah, this is the new one.
That's so much hit points.
so much
health on that minion.
This is again going into that warrior taunt stuff. Continuing to try to build up taunt warrior as a thing. The warrior quest is actually about playing taunts as well, so that'll be important. But this is quite good. I mean, it's a 1/11 taunt that becomes a 5/11 taunt during your opponent's turn. So pretty beefy. Okay. Here's Razor Petal Volley. Add 2 Razor Petals to your hand that deal 1 damage. So this is again like the other Razor Petal thing I mentioned. I've heard some people saying it's pretty poor, because you then have to play those Razor Petals and they cost 1 mana each.
Mm-hmm.
So that's not great. Air Elemental Shaman, 1-cost minion, can't be targeted by spells or hero powers. So it's it's a 2/1 that can't get taken out at least by mage. Is that?
Yeah.
Again, probably fits into an elemental deck. All right, look at that cute guy. Here's the Stegadon, a 2/6 with taunt. This is what you get from the
That paladin card.
Paladin card.
Stegadon mount or whatever it was.
Yeah, so like, you not only give your person +2/+6, But you also get this when they die, which is pretty, pretty powerful. Alright, we've got the Stormwatcher here. Oh wait, we did see that before. Evolving Spores is cool. 4-cost druid spell, adapt your minions.
Wow, okay, so all of them.
All of them with one adapt, again.
Right, just like the Paladin card.
Yeah, just like the Paladin card. So you choose one adapt, and it goes on all of your minions, which
Hello.
Is interesting.
That's a pretty good pack.
2 tear scale stalkers.
And those guys look pretty creepy.
Trigger a friendly minion's death rattle. So this is kind of like the Princess Huhuron, the old hunter legendary, but I think kind of shows how weak that legendary was. Fireplume Harbinger is a elemental for shamans. 2 costs, reduce the cost of elementals in your hand by 1. It's a battle cry, so
battle
it's not
cry,
just when
but...
it's in play, it's permanent. Yeah. And then the Gluttonous Ooze, destroy your opponent's weapon and gain armor equal to its attack. Again, a thing to help slow down those sort of rush.
Yeah. Now, how does that compare to our old Ooze, who typically destroys your opponent's weapon?
I mean,
other than the armor thing, obviously. Like
the big difference, obviously, is the big difference. It's a 3-2, and the big difference, of course, being that you play that on turn 2. You know, potentially Gluttonous Ooze is a little bit slower, but the trade off is that you're getting armor as well as destroying the weapon. Yeah. And then one more health, which, you know, probably isn't a huge deal. I like that there's more options. I like that you can have a few more options now. Here's just a big old Ultrasaur. I love his face. It's so good.
Yeah, it's a good face.
And it's a 7-14.
That's
a beast.
Big.
Yeah, it's pretty big. And then the Sabertooth Stalker, an 8-2 with stealth. So obviously very, very powerful, but also very, you know, can be taken out by a lot of different border clear options, especially that late in the game.
Yeah.
But if you can adapt it. Okay. We've got the Ornery Direhorn, another warrior taunt here with the battle cry of adapt, 6 cost, 5, 5 with adapt. Not bad. It's all right. Earthen Scales, give a friendly minion +1/+1, and then gain armor equal to its attack. Which is pretty cool.
Yeah, and 1 cost. That's pretty good.
It's not bad. I don't know if it'll see play, but it's not bad.
I can see that working in a Jade Druid deck.
Sure, I could definitely see that, yeah.
You need to slow things down.
Here's the Crystalline Oracle, 1 cost, 1/1 with a death rattle. Copy a card from your opponent's deck and add it to your hand. Classic priest stuff there. I love priest abilities that are just about stealing your opponent's stuff. because I am a jerk, and that's what I like to do. I like to steal my opponent's stuff and use their own stuff to destroy them.
It's true. You are a jerk.
Thank you. here's the new shaman spell, Volcano. 5 cost, overload 2, but you're dealing 15 damage. But split amongst all minions. Minions
I feel like
only.
That's going to be a spell that I'm going to want to mute my computer when it's played.
Maybe, yeah. That could be. And then you've got the Stone Sentinel. 7 cost, 4/4, but your battle cry is if you played an elemental last turn, summon 2/3 elementals with taunt.
That is pretty beefy.
So you're basically getting like Spirit Wolves plus a 4/4 body. That's an elemental, so you can potentially trigger other elemental stuff in the following turn. So it's pretty, it's not bad. It's less bad than it looks when you see a 7 cost 4/4.
Yeah.
Here's the, look at this cute
pterodactyl hatchling.
Battle cry adapt. Here's another turtle, the Shell Shifter. 4 cost 3/3.
All right.
And you can transform it into a 5/3 with stealth or a 3/5 with taunt.
Now, is Fandral Staghelm still in standard?
I believe so. Fandral still is. Let me pull up and check just to be sure.
I can't remember if he's in the classic set or not.
He's not in the classic set, but I believe he is recent enough. Yeah, he was in he was in Whispers of the Old Gods, so.
Right.
You're still good on Fandral, so potentially you could get a
5/5
there. Nothing good there. just the regular stuff. Oh, I love this pre-spell, Free from Amber. Discover a minion that costs 8 or more, summon it.
Whoa.
I have a colleague from Vox Media who has been playing already in the new...
Shall remain nameless, I guess.
Yeah, I don't want to call anyone out here, but this colleague sent me a screenshot of a game they had played today where they played Yogg. And their Yogg-Saron kept playing Free from Amber.
Oh my gosh.
So they just got a bunch of 8... Their board was empty, and then they played Yogg and just got a bunch of 8-cost minions, which is lovely. It's so good.
Yeah, that's beautiful. That's a good story.
Here's that Obsidian Shard. That's the stuff that you want from Yogg, I feel like.
Yeah.
Oh, this turtle's a... He's a trickster.
I love how much you're into the turtles.
I love them. They're so good. This one, the art in general in this expansion, I love like almost all of it. But
and to be honest, like I am unfamiliar with the man turtle race of Warcraft.
Tortolans, they're named, I guess.
They show up?
In my opinion, they should be beasts. The fact that they're not beasts is a problem. But
that's Phil. They walk upright. Mm. They have a concept of theft.
Listen, we'll talk about this later. But that said, the Eggnapper is good. Death Rattle of Summon 2/1/1 Raptors is good.
That is pretty good.
Humongous Razor Leaf is also pretty good. It's a 4/8 for 3, but it can't attack. Whoops. Oopsie.
Yeah.
So you're going to need like a silence or something, or a taunt, I guess. Turn it into a taunt.
You can always adapt it.
I guess so.
Theoretically, I guess.
Here's the new paladin weapon, the Vine Cleaver. It's a 4/3 weapon. After your hero attacks, summon 2/1/1 Silverhand recruits. I love everything about this weapon except for the fact that it's 7 cost. It's just too much.
Yeah.
I think if it was like a 5 cost, or maybe even a 6 cost, and had one less charge,
mm-hmm.
or maybe just summoned one recruit, it would be a lot better.
Yeah.
It's just a little too high, but I do love it in theory at least. Oh, Golden Ultrasaur. Look at him. He opens his mouth at me. 2 Primal Fin Totems, new Shaman Totem. At the end of your turn, summon a 1/1 Murloc.
I had not seen that card before.
I love the art. Again, like the art on this is so good.
That's a totem
that's dressed up to attract
Murlocs.
Yeah. Ancient Murloc mating ritual.
The totem dressed up as a very sexy androgynous Murloc.
Yeah.
I guess Murlocs are already pretty androgynous. Who knows?
They're
fish people. Like.
I don't know enough about Murloc culture to comment really.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here's an interesting new druid spell, Living Mana. Transform your mana crystals into 2/2 minions. Recover the mana when they die.
That is wild. Like,
it's pretty wild.
Definitely something where it's like, I honestly look forward to seeing what crazy things people do with that.
It's going to be interesting. And then we've got the Emerald Reaver here, which is a 1-cost 2/1, deals 1 damage to each hero when you play it. I don't know. It's a 1-cost beast, so it might make its way into some hunter stuff, maybe.
So we've only gotten 2 legendaries so far, right?
Only 2.
And they're both quest cards.
Both quest cards, yep.
Alright.
There are legendary quests for every class and legendary minions for every class. So there's actually more legendaries than normal.
Hello.
Speaking of.
Yeah.
Ooh, another golden here. Direhorn Hatchling.
Look at that baby Triceratops.
I really dig this one as well. So another warrior taunt. It's a 5-cost 3/6. With the death rattle of shuffle a 6/9 Direhorn with taunt into your deck.
Huh.
And check out those stats. Do you see it?
I see. They are look, nice.
Thank you. That's what I was waiting for. here's the Vorax. After you cast a spell on this minion, summon a 1/1 plant and cast another copy on it.
Okay, yeah.
So what's cool about this, it's a 4-cost 3/3, which isn't great, but if you're in like a buff deck, if you're in like a priest or more likely a paladin buff deck, I think there's a lot of potential for this, particularly late game when you can play it and then immediately cast a spell on it.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of potential for this
or,
to be real good.
Or multiple spells on it.
Yeah, exactly. So I really want to make this work is what I'm trying to say. I really want to make it work. So I'm going to try.
Yeah.
I'm excited that that's my first legendary minion I've got. What do we got? Good stuff. Good dust. Dust it all. Dust all of this. Don't even care. Dust.
Yep.
Envenom weapon is a cool one. This is a new rogue spell. 3 cost. Give your weapon poisonous. So even just with your regular dagger, suddenly it has 2 charges where you just know that you're going to be able to remove whatever you swing at, which is pretty powerful.
Yeah.
Fine stuff, I guess.
So we've gotten 3 legendaries in about 40 packs.
Yeah. Which feels normal-ish. Again, the fact that there's more legendaries in this expansion than anyone previously is kind of interesting. It's kind of I'm surprised I haven't heard more people bring it up as like a point of contention. Because it seems like it means you'll have to essentially get more packs before you have everything. Or devote a lot more dust.
Yeah.
Luckily, I have a lot of dust. And these goldens will help.
Now, I can't remember exactly the changes they made to Arena. But is Arena standard now?
Arena is standard now.
So all of the changes that we're seeing here apply to Arena as well.
Here's an interesting Warlock Beast minion. Ravenous Pterodax, destroy a friendly minion to adapt twice.
Mm-hmm.
4 cost, 4/4, which isn't bad stats. If you've got something minor that you can destroy, if you've got an egg, destroy that egg and then adapt twice. Potential there. So all the stuff that rotated out today has rotated out of Arena as well. Although there may still be people running their old arena runs with old cards.
Yeah, that happened to me the last time they made a big change to Arena, and I did a couple runs on that and then just retired it.
Oh.
So I was getting creamed. Right. I mean, I guess that's not.
Here's the.
Yeah, go ahead.
I was going to say, here's the Volcanosaur. This is the card they actually gave out yesterday as a login reward.
Yeah, they gave out a gold Volcanosaur.
Yeah, and what was interesting, what I didn't realize initially, is it was playable yesterday immediately. So I actually added it into my Jade Druid deck and was rolling around with that just to see if it would catch anyone off guard because they didn't realize it was playable. All right. Okay, nothing good there. Trash, garbage.
Dust.
Ugh, that was like the same pack, I feel like. I feel like I just opened a repeat. Ooh.
Oh.
Here is legendary number 4, it looks like. Jungle Giants, so here's the druid one. Summon 5 minions with 5 or more attack. And then I believe I'm going to pull up the stats here for Barnabas. But Barnabas is not only a big minion in and of himself.
And you get the joke there, right?
No, what's the joke?
Phil, think about what would you call a guy named Barnabas for short?
I don't get it.
You'd call him Barney.
Barnabas the Stomper. He's a 5 cost 8/8, but here's the crazy part. The battle cry, reduce the cost of minions in your deck to 0.
Wow, and that's not like a card text.
That's
it's a
battle cry. That is a battle cry. So for the rest of your game. Interesting card.
What is that, Steam Surger? I don't think I've seen that before.
I flew past it.
Phil does not care.
All I want is legendaries now. If we see it pop up again, I'll stop.
Yeah.
I got too excited about Barnabas. And whatever it was you were trying to say.
the terrible joke I was telling you about that you've chosen to ignore.
Servant of Kalamos. This is a neutral elemental. If you played an elemental last turn, discover an elemental. 5 cost, 4/5. Not bad. It's all right. Probably a place for that in some elemental decks, right? We're up to 4 legendaries.
Yep.
Gotta keep track. Gotta know what we do here. Dinomancy.
Yes. I want that so bad.
Yeah. This is really rad, and I'm super interested to see if and how it works. New hunter spell. Your hero power becomes give a beast +2/+2.
Yeah. If that's randomly chosen, give a beast 2/+2, or just you pick a beast, you give it 2/+2.
I think it's random. I don't know. I guess I don't know. Because we gotta find out.
Like, if it's random, then it could potentially give your opponent's beasts 2/2.
That could be bad. I bet it won't do that. Here's a new Murloc, the Rockpool Hunter.
Yep.
Give a friendly Murloc +1/+1. Yeah, I don't know. Either way, I think it's that Hunter thing is very interesting, and I want to see if people can make it work, because I want it to work. Here's another Turtle Bro. The Stonehill Defender.
Is that a hat? Or is that something behind him?
You know, it's hard to say.
It's hard to say because you made the cards go away.
I don't think that turtles should be allowed to wear hats.
Yeah?
But this goes on to my stance.
I think that should be reserved for people. Because you think they should be beasts, so they're not.
I think
people.
They should be. It goes beasts back to my hats. Stance about I think turtles are beasts, therefore. Ooh, golden one. I've got my 15th volcano. What do we got? All right. Hey, Susana.
Yes, Phil, it's very nice.
Thank you.
Are you proud?
I just couldn't. I had to.
No, yeah, no. Well, you have to complete the incantation.
I need validation. So.
Steal the tomb. These are the shibboleths. This is the language of our times.
There's that stone sentinel again. Not too bad. Oh, here's the new mage spell, Meteor. Deal 15 damage
overkill.
To a minion. So they specifically said the way that they decided this is they wanted Meteor to be a spell that could kill literally any dinosaur.
Mm-hmm.
And the highest health dinosaur is 15.
Yeah. That's thematically appropriate.
So, there you go. But then 3 damage to adjacent ones as well, which is nice. It's absolutely overkill. Here's a cool new Warlock spell, Corrupting Mist. Corrupt every minion, destroy them at the start of your next turn. So it's sort of like a Doomsayer, except A, it can't be killed, but B, it will not destroy things that are played after you've done it. So
yeah,
it's sort of like a give and take.
And gives your opponent every excuse to just bash all of those minions into whatever you're doing for a turn.
Golden Tarlurker there. But it is cool, and I like seeing, you know, new board clear options is always good. Especially as the game gets crazier minions. Mimic Pod. Draw a card, then add a copy of it to your hand.
Yeah, that's how you get that rogue quest done.
So this is like a mini Thistletea, basically. Which is not bad. Less bad than Thistletea, probably. Okay, we've seen all those. Oh, he's dancing.
Oh, look at that guy.
Is this the one that I skipped over?
Yeah.
Battlecry, if you played an elemental last turn, add a Flame Geyser to your hand. And then
now what is Flame Geyser?
Flame Geyser, I believe, is the spell. The one that does 2 damage and then adds a... Yeah, deal 2 damage and add a 1/2 elemental to your hand. So essentially, right, you're getting a spell and another elemental after you play that spell as well. And then now, here's this adorable turtle bro.
That's some pretty good card text right there.
Discover a spell and cast it with random targets. Probably.
That's fun.
I mean, if you're running a Yogg deck already, you might as well just embrace it, I guess. There's that cruel Dynomancer again.
Yep.
So my discard lock is coming along nicely. Okay. Another Biteweed. I like Biteweed because of the name Biteweed. There's another legendary.
5.
This will be number 5. Ooh, Golden Vine Cleaver. Oh, come on.
Well, you wanted that one, Phil.
I didn't want it that bad. Also, I mean, like, it's one of those cards, like, you've had this, where you see a card get announced, and you're like, I want that because I want to make it work, even though you know deep in your heart it's never going to.
Yeah. Yeah, I got lucky that, Call of the Wild turned out to be pretty powerful for Hunters.
Oh, yeah.
I saw that card and was like immediately like, I need that.
I also was pro Call of the Wild from the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay, we got that. The usual garbage cards. Once I've discovered a card, like, once I've found a copy of it, it's just, what's the point, right?
It's just the worst, yeah. Same shit, different pack.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, 80 packs, 5 legendaries. That's not a bad ratio.
It's not terrible. One of them's a repeat, I don't like that. Ooh, Stampede. Each time you play a beast this turn, add a random beast to your hand. So this is basically like lock and load, but for beasts, which is pretty cool.
Man, there was a period where lock and load was a really strong hunter deck, and I very much enjoyed my lock and load combos.
Oh yeah, lock and load's a blast. Even as no longer a strong card, it's like a lot of fun to play.
Yeah.
Golden Radiant Elemental, I'll take that.
Very Radiant Elemental.
Extra Radiant. Exceedingly Radiant Elemental.
That Elemental has been moisturizing.
Ooh. Golden Bad Spell.
Phil, what if there was a Hearthstone card that was just called Bad Spell?
It would probably help me. Here's an interesting one. 1 costs 2/3, your minions cost 2 more.
Huh. That doesn't seem good.
I mean, it's interesting. I don't think it's probably great.
I mean, I guess it would. You'd play it early on, and then it would probably get destroyed pretty quick, I guess?
I guess if you're running one of those, like, trying to play as many 1-cost minions as possible, that's a 1-cost that has slightly better stats. Do you feel like there are enough dinos in this?
I feel like the amount of dinosaurs is really, it's really doing it for me.
I know dinos are a thing that you were particularly looking forward to.
Yeah, no, Phil, the moment that I realized that I was probably done with World of Warcraft emotionally was when I realized that I hadn't logged on since the last patch, and that it had been a month since the last patch. And the last patch was the one that put in rideable Triceratops.
Oh. And if
rideable Triceratops were not a thing that could get me to play World of Warcraft, I was probably done with it.
Yeah. Yeah,
it was
that's
a real, it was a moment of truth.
It was like a come-to-Jesus thing.
Yeah.
You had to finally accept.
Come to Dinosaur Jesus. Raptor Jesus. Like, that's a meme, right?
I think it's a thing.
I've been on the internet for a while.
I actually have never been on the internet. Mm-hmm. I'm told that it's not a very nice place.
Yeah. I mean, I've met some nice people on the internet. A few.
I'm just gonna bounce on through these now because we're getting to the dregs here where we've seen all we need to see pretty much except for these legendaries. Give me the legendaries or get out.
Hello.
This is another repeat.
No, Phil.
So that's my sixth, but two of them are repeats. Also, I got that golden. I thought it was a golden legendary for a second. I was real stoked. But sadly, that was not the case.
So I can see people's point with more legendaries means having to craft more legendaries. But since the quest cards are so class-specific, and some of them are so such to the point where it's like, you have to want to craft to make exactly that deck.
Here's one we haven't seen. Mm-hmm. Is the Chittering Tunneler, new Warlock, 3 cost, 3/3. Discover a spell and deal damage to your hero equal to its cost. Interesting. One of those, like, playing with your health as a resource things. Yeah. Probably a little harder to actually use in a post-Reno world, but...
Yeah, because what I'm saying is that, like, I've been pretty frustrated with, like, the pressure to craft patches, even though I don't like, I'm not super into playing pirate decks.
Sure.
But he's just, like, so mandatory for, like, a bunch of rush decks in the current meta that I've been resistant to crafting him because I didn't get him when I got my packs, and, you know, I haven't got him in any packs since, and...
I did give in to crafting patches, but I would say, like, if you don't play rush decks, just don't even worry about it.
Yeah, and I think that like maybe what sort of mitigates the fact that there are more legendaries in this expansion is that they're like a lot of them are very, very specific to do you want to play this one kind of deck that this one kind of class does.
Sure. I mean that's true. I mean I guess the problem becomes with problem, quote unquote. Mm-hmm. It's a good problem to have, but like if the meta is strong and there's a lot of different decks that are good and you want to try out different decks, there's a higher cost.
Right.
Because of the higher number of legendaries, there's a higher cost to actually having all of the pieces in place, in theory, to test these.
Yeah.
Although, I guess I haven't looked. It's possible that there are just less neutral legendaries this time, but the same amount of total legendaries, but less neutral. That could be. All these goldens, though, I'm going to be set.
Yeah.
I'm just going to craft everything.
Now, the last time we did one of these, you told me that you don't disenchant your goldens.
I actually don't. I'll show the process when we finish opening up here, but no, I keep all my goldens. I can't. They're too nice. They're too pretty.
I keep them when they generate other cards.
I don't even disenchant them once they go to wild, which is like the worst part. Like I don't play wild, but I still have to keep them.
Mm-hmm.
All right, lots of good stuff. We're getting down here.
Yep. Final 10.
It's your last chance, Hearthstone, to impress me. Give me like 4 legendaries. Spirit Echo. Give your minions death rattle. Return this to your hand.
Hmm.
Kind of an interesting thing there. I don't know if Shaman is necessarily situated to get the most use out of that, but it's interesting nonetheless. Right.
Yeah, there's always something weird about being a Shaman and playing one of your basic 4 totems from your hand. It feels unnatural.
Yes.
Hello.
Ooh, here we go. Speaking of...
I don't want to presume, but that seems like a stoner's card.
Summon 10 Murlocs. Your reward is Megafin. And Megafin is a 5-cost 8/8 with the battle cry, fill your hand with random murlocs. So just your whole hand gets full of yummy, yummy murlocs. We've also got Blood Bloom, which is a 2-cost warlock spell. The next spell you cast this turn costs health instead of mana. Sort of the same effect that Cho'Gall did, the legendary card Cho'Gall, but now as a cheap spell. It's kind of interesting. All right, here we go. Last one. Come on, 5 legendaries. Dang.
Nope. Just your average little pack.
Bummer. Well, let's take a look at what our death situation is. So I've got 8,000 dust.
God, that's so much.
That's from the 60. What was it, like 6,800 of that or something? Is from Look at all of it. They're all wild now because I don't. Anyways, 4,600 from disenchanted.
That's a nice even number. That's so much dust.
Yeah. So let's check out here. Yeah, so like in this case, I'll disenchant one of these regular ones and keep my gold one. Because I need it. I need that gold.
I respect that, Phil. I respect that.
But this is still a lot. I'll still have a lot of stuff, right? Somebody wants to duel me.
Tell them you're busy. Very important Hearthstone business.
Well, anyways, we don't need to do this. You don't need to see me disenchant all my stuff. But this is Journey to Angoro. We've opened a whole bunch of cards. I'm gonna start immediately messing around, building some decks, and I think the plan. And of course, you are welcome to join me, Susana, if you're interested. Mm-hmm. Next week, Blizzard wants to actually have one of the developers come on. Come on stream with us and do like a sort of test run of some of the decks.
I'll take a look at my schedule.
Check out some of the coolest new decks that that have popped up so far. So yeah, if you're down for that, we would love to have you. And hopefully everybody watching will check that out. Hopefully we can get Griffin in as well, since he was not able to join us for this.
But
I know he's opening a bunch of his own packs at this point as well. So, and you have packs to open also, right, Susan?
Yes, I do. Gonna probably get on that after work.
After
work? Like a responsible person.
What do you? I only ever play Hearthstone during work. Is that bad? Don't tell the boss.
No, I won't tell Chris Brandt. I promise.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We will be back with more Hearthstone Journey to Angoro content soon.